Welcome back to the Evan Whitton Hour YouTube channel, the home of album reviews, discography guides, and think pieces. Now today, my friends, is time for episode 6 of the Not-So-Forensic Record Society. I know I've probably hyped this into oblivion, but it's finally here, and it would be with my good friend, Mr. Fumedeus, who, like I say, is a good friend of mine, very, very funny man, very, very charismatic character, very unpredictable character, so I knew it was going to be a really great episode just from the off. But where it really got unpredictable was with the introduction of a second guest that I didn't plan. Because what happened was, after the first part where we just exchanged the songs, that was just me and him. But then when it got to the verdict part, him and another one of my friends called Shingorin, he kind of enlisted his help in putting his own verdict forward. And so I'm sat there in the Zoom call, and then all of a sudden I see Fumedeus, I let him in, and then I see Shingorin pop up in the waiting room, and I get, you know, Fumedeus in my ear going, oh, let him in. And then the next hour was perhaps one of the most frustrating, confusing, but also looking back at it, one of the most hilarious hours of recording I think I've ever done. I mean, this is how unpredictable it is. It even got to the point where I think Fumedeus planning to do his whole verdict part down the phone from our local park. I mean, luckily I managed to wrangle him indoors, but I wouldn't be surprised if he still did it down the phone, because this one, audio-wise, was a nightmare to edit, so I do apologise if there's any kind of volume inconsistencies, but this was a great episode. Like, it says a lot that out of the hour and 15 minutes of footage, only really 25 minutes of it was usable. These two together, just as a duo, are complete agents of chaos, and, you know, as much as that may have frustrated me at the time, it is still very funny to watch and made for a very great episode, so I do hope you all enjoy it. Also, as a fun little bonus, I didn't know until afterwards, but Shingorin had recorded the entire Zoom via his own Nvidia screen capture. And granted, you can't really see the Zoom screen because of like how Nvidia works and stuff, but like the audio is incredible because it is just me just questioning what the hell is going on. And I think as much as it was frustrating at the time, like I say, it's really funny watching back. So I made sure to put a bit of it in there for your own viewing pleasure. So let's just get on with it, shall we? So hello everybody, and welcome back to episode number 6 of the Not So Forensic Record Society. I am your regular host, but with me today is yet another special guest. We had a special guest last episode. It was very nice. Today we have a special guest in the form of my good friend, Mr. Fumedeus.
I have got to say, the best guest so far, obviously.
For those of you that don't know, every time, each episode, me and my co-host get together 9 songs of a variety of styles, artists to listen to and report back on, and make the other person cry, hopefully, is the optimum outcome.
So for the first two, I chose the longest song just to annoy Evan and make him suffer. First one is Runaway by Kanye.
No, not Kanye again.
The second one is one that I chose just because I know how much you hate the song, Genocide by Lil Darky.
I mean, I've not heard it, but I know it's the one that's like 11 minutes.
The third one, Teen Titans Blow by Soft Willie.
Wait, what's that?
Teen Titans Blow by Soft Willie.
Yeah. Where have you gone to find this? I'm just waiting for our Discord to vote. You just sent me a flipping Pornhub link. Like, I'm not...
Number 4 is called Evan Poop Song.
Jesus.
That is one of my favourites. Moving on to 5, I've got... This is a... Someone requested me to this. It's Noah's. And it's Sicko Mode by Travis Scott.
This might not be that bad.
The next one, I know you'll enjoy, because it's from Yungblud and its parents. Oh. Next one is the Stereotype song. Just, I want to see your opinions on it. Then there's Where Are You Nino. It's a good song. Good lyric. Good lyrics. The last but not least, a Juice WRLD song, and it's Robbery. Okay, that's not bad. It's not that bad. That one's all right.
From what I can glean, it's a lot of rap. Some of it sounds all right, and some of it I have no idea what the hell I'm getting myself into.
I've got to admit, one of the songs I haven't even listened to yet.
Are you taking the piss? Are you actually taking the piss? I don't really know what happened with this, because normally I have sort of a framework of like what the other person likes to try and go into it. But for you, I didn't really have that. Sort of looked over my choices afterwards and I was like, a lot of them are weirdly trippy for like no reason whatsoever. And I don't really understand why. So the first one that I recommended to you is a song by a band called Electric Wire Hustle, called Light Goes a Long Way, I believe is the title. It's just a very chill jam. There's a lot of drumming in it that's quite impressive, actually. This is a playlist, I think, on the whole, that you need a good pair of headphones for. It takes a while to get going, but you just gotta sort of be patient with it, just bear with it. The second one, a song by a project called The Microphones,
called The Moon. I don't really know how to describe this one either. I looked it up on Wikipedia and the genres were like lo-fi, indie, psychedelic. It's very strangely structured and it sounds quite odd, but for some reason I find myself enjoying it quite a lot. The next song is one that I hope you will like, and that is Madness, Sun and the Rain. I was in a musical production of it at school, and this was easily my favourite song in the whole show. The fourth song is a song by Augustus Pablo called Each One Dub. This is like some of the best reggae you'll find. You need some proper good headphones because like the bass on this is monumental. Fifth song is a song by a band called Massive Attack, and it's called Unfinished Sympathy. Way back, like way loads of years ago, I used to do like wheelchair racing down at a track. We had this playlist, me and my dad, that we would sort of cycle through. And this one came up all the time. And I just remember thinking it was great. And I dug it up again, like last year or maybe the year before. And I thought it was great. The next one is a song by a guy called Willie J. Healy called Fashion. Yeah. And I thought you'd like this because it's a bit sort of a, it's like a 60s retro Beatles type thing, but sort of modernised. The seventh one is a song by Black Sabbath called Methodemic. Black Sabbath, you can't really go wrong. This is probably one of the faster ones because they tend to do quite slow, long songs. So I tried to not give you one that was like 12 minutes because I'm a nice person. The next one is a song by an artist called Rat Boy called Get Over It. I saw him at Bingley Music Live maybe 3 years ago now, and I thought it was great, and so I properly dug into his back catalogue afterwards. It is festival music, like it's the sort of stuff you'd hear at a festival or maybe like at a party. It's like stereotypical party music. The final song, it wouldn't be me if I didn't recommend you at least one Prodigy song, and it's called Wild Frontier. I picked this because it sounds exactly what you would think a Prodigy song from 2015 to sound like, but it's also one of their more accessible ones, one of their more catchy ones. So you can probably get into it a bit easier than you could Firestarter, say, for instance. We'll see you, I think, in just under a week's time, I think, where we've listened to the songs, made notes, and then we will come back and shout at each other. So we will cut to that now. Why are you here? What? I don't know why.
Hello? Can you hear me?
Like, go away. Go away.
So my three songs...
Oh, shut up, Jack, you stupid.
He's not recording yet,
I'm kicking you out.
Just start it.
Why is he here? You do not understand how much I hate this.
Right now, Jack's just a special guest. Introduce Jack.
Why? What point, what purpose does he serve?
I need help. I give Jack the document. Okay.
What?
Yeah, I give Jack the document, and then he's me. He's the only one who knows which one's which.
Well, why did he do that?
It was an accident, bro.
Let's carry on.
Why?
Yeah,
I'm
in my mic.
Mixed up. How the hell are we supposed to even do this?
No, because Jack knows which one's which.
Oh, well, brilliant. Fantastic.
Yeah. That's why it was funny.
Recording in progress.
So it is verdict time. It is time to have a big shouty argument with apparently another special guest who's just turned up randomly. This is Mr. Shingorin. So what I wasn't aware of is that these two have basically been each other's accomplice in doing this. So your first song for me, George, if I'm not mistaken, was Runaway by Kanye West, the second Kanye West song we've had on this series. I thought the instrumental itself wasn't too bad, apart from just being a little messy for my tastes. I thought everything else sounded nice, apart from the weird voice that came in every so often and just sounded bad. I thought Kanye's voice was quite decent, especially in the chorus, but the verses I thought were really annoying, and that email line genuinely makes me cringe every time I hear it.
No, I disagree.
No, that how can you like, I'm sending a bitch a picture of my dick in an email.
Yeah, that's a good bit of the song.
No, it isn't. I thought the general lyrical sentiment of it was decent, though. I thought the guest verse on it was all right. Nothing especially mind-blowing from the guest. I thought Pusha T's guest verse was all right. I mean, it wasn't anything really mind-blowing, but I mean, it was all right. But the last 3 minutes of this song absolutely do my shitting head in, because it's just 3 minutes of Kanye West into a microphone going...
No, it's good.
You can search Runaway Outro on YouTube. I can guarantee you, if you look in the comments, after 5 minutes, you will want to jump out of a window. This part of the song annoys me so much,
and it is what makes me detest this song. So I want to like this song, but because of the last 3 minutes of it, I can't say that I like it. Let's have a toast for the douchebags. Let's have a toast for the assholes.
Let's have a toast for the scumbags. Every one of them that I know. Right, so my first song was Light Goes a Long Way by Electric Wire Hustle. I thought that the music was very good. The beat was very good. I liked the beat. That was good. The lyrics need a bit of work. Yeah. Overall, decent song. It needs to be the right mood to listen to.
Oh, yeah, I get that.
I would say it's quite atmospheric, the song.
Shut up, Jack. This is my... Why are you saying my notes? One of my notes was it was very atmospheric. And I felt really good listening to it at points, but then, like, if I were in a shit mood, I wouldn't want to listen to it.
George, you also said it, like, aroused your interest in that kind of music.
No, I didn't. That's a lie. Jack's trying shit.
Your second one was Genocide by Little Darkie. I hated this so much. I'm not even going to lie. I hated this.
How many times did you listen to it?
Once, and I couldn't even get through it. I listened to about 8 minutes.
What? You didn't finish the song?
I listened to it.
How inconsiderate.
Shut up, man. This is not like you going, oh, I listened to 40 seconds and then moved on. I sat there for 9 minutes listening to this, and I'm like, there's 2 more minutes of this. I'm not going to do it. Because lyrically, it's just the most unfunny thing I've ever heard. It's just like edginess with no substance to it at all. It was genuinely depressing. And the fact that people enjoy this unironically is genuinely like magic. Sorry, my apologies for coming off so harshly. Impart me second
chance so I can dance the way you want me. You Nazi got me. The Moon by The Microphones. I thought the lyrics were actually decent, to be fair. The music sucked my cock.
We're not leaving that there.
I know, what he meant to say was he likes the acoustic beat of it, and he likes the bit where it starts
to get
the beat increases about a minute and a half.
Stop reading my notes.
No, you said, you accidentally missaid your line.
I thought it was pretty good, to be honest. I was surprised by your options. To be fair, by the time I got to The Moon, there was no skin off my ass. So by the time I got to the end of this one, I did kind of want a shit. So I went for a shit. And then...
That's why I know quite a bit about this song, because I was sat listening to it by myself for 15 minutes. In my opinion, like, the lyrics are a bit like...
At least it wasn't awful.
Yeah, it was terrible, yeah.
So my next song from you was Teen Titans Blow. I actually thought the beat was decent because I thought the organ in it was really cool. And I thought the beat itself just sounded really good. But the lyrics, anybody could make like a funny gay joke. But when all you're doing is like the most over-the-top gay jokes over and over and over for like 90 seconds straight, it beats the joke to death.
The lyric that I really liked the most was... When there's evil on the attack, I will know all over its back. That really spoke big words to me.
It was kind of inspirational in a
way. It was inspirational.
Like, I thought it was kind of funny for like the first 15 seconds and I got tired of it very quickly. But I thought the beat was good. So.
Sun and the rain. Sorry, by the Madness.
Right, so
good song. It was pretty good.
Is that it? Do not tell me that is all you wrote for this.
Beat is really cheesy.
Beats were pretty good.
The beat was doggish, in my opinion.
This is what you gotta understand. This was the early 80s.
It seems like someone's got a keyboard and they've used one finger to play the entire thing. To play the entire keyboard thing.
Yeah, you've got Jack, what the fuck are you on about?
How the hell are you going to play that with one finger?
The flute where it went... That bit is my favourite, bro.
The next song from you was Evan Pooh's song. The artist title, I believe, was... The Odd Man Who Sings About Poop, Puke and Pee. I don't even know what I'm supposed to say to this. Like, I know that, like, our good buddy Gallagher, like, he has a precedent of sending me meme songs, which is all well and good. But this is just like, this isn't even funny. Like, this is just the guy singing the words Evan and poop over the most generic piano music I think I've ever heard in my life. Like, he's not even as if he, like, if he literally just came on and went, Evan is a poo sniffer, that would have been more funny than what this actually was.
Sit, Evan's a poo sniffer.
Yeah, if he came on and one of the lyrics was Evan is a poo sniffer, that would be way funnier than what it actually was.
How does the song go again?
It goes a bit like, poo sniffer, Evan, poo, poo. Can't remember, I didn't listen to the song.
But yes, it was very boring and very unfunny.
Evan poop, Evan poop, Evan, Evan, Evan poop, Evan poop.
Oh, it's my turn, I forgot, sorry Evan. Right, I'll do number 5, then I'll do number 4. Yeah?
What?
Each one dub.
Yes.
Right, so I'll do fashion. Right, so fashion.
No. We're going to do them in order. That's how the show works.
I don't want to do them in order.
You're gonna do them in order, George.
Yeah, why? George.
Because that's how the show works.
Yeah, you silly Billy Willy.
Oh, do you want me to give you my opinion on the song now?
Yes. On each one dub, please.
Right. Yeah, we're good lot. Yeah, it's all right, to be fair.
I'm not a big fan of, like, the reggae beat kind of thing that's going on.
What's his notes? Just tell me what his notes are, and then we can get this.
Yeah, read out your notes.
Let me do my notes.
You were supposed to do them then, and you just went, yeah, it's good, lad. And then, like, just didn't say anything.
Jack, why have you wrote that? Jack just wrote, Evan's a poo sniffer on the document.
I did not. I think that if you played that 1.25 times speed, or even 1.5, it would sound like a normal song. It feels like it's played in slow motion.
I feel like when Jack fingers his bum, like this is what he's going to listen to whilst he's doing it. Well,
is that what you put in your notes? I swear to, please don't say that's what you put in your notes.
My opinion, lyrics. I feel like it just doesn't reach climax at all. Like, it just goes, it's constant for the entire thing.
Yeah, each one dub, overall, pretty decent. Pretty shit, won't listen to it again. Pretty good, pretty shit.
So, your next song was Sicko Mode by Travis Scott featuring Drake. I thought the Drake intro was kind of redundant and pointless and just goes on for a bit too long with, like, nothing interesting about it. The main chorus verse bit with Travis on it after the beat switches was actually quite nice and is probably the best bit of the song. Drake's actual guest verse comes in at the end. That is just really, really boring. So, I thought there were 3 parts to this song, 2 of which I didn't think were very interesting and both of which involved Drake. I thought Travis' bit was easily the best bit, but when he's, like, doing background vocals on Drake's bit, he's turned up way too loud, so that made that annoying as well.
Make this here with all the ice on in the booth. At the gate outside, when they pull up, they give me loose. Yeah, jump out, boys, that's Nike boys hopping our coast. This shit way too...
Right, so the next one was Unfinished Sympathy. Massive Attack. Yeah, right, your turn.
No, we're not doing this again.
Okay. Yeah. Good beat. Jack, stop putting shit on the document.
Didn't put anything on the document.
Jack, right. Stop putting literal shit on the document. He's put copy and pasting pictures of shit.
I've not done anything. Right, I would say my opinion. I really liked the keyboard, like the piano.
It's not your segment, Jack. Shut up.
I really liked that bit. Like, do you know, like, in the middle? Do you know which bit I'm on about?
No, because you just said the bit in the middle.
Do you know, like, the bit? You know what I'm on about? It's the good bit. If just think about the good bit of the song, it's that bit.
Are you talk about the bit that just has, like, the string bits in it?
Yeah, it was pretty good. Like, I liked it. Like, it vibe it.
Right,
what
about you, Jack?
No, fuck Jack. Jack should politely fuck off.
The woman's voice kind of got a bit annoying. Like, as it kept on going on, it was just, like, the same lines over and over again. It sounded like they were just picking the same thing over and over.
Your next song was Parents by Yungblud. I hate it as well, and let me explain why. Because it's, like, desperately trying to be edgy and provocative. I thought the instrumental was boring. I thought, even though it tried to be edgy, it's desperately trying to appeal to, like, millions of people and sell loads of records. So it's, like, very counterintuitive. It was a stereotypical Parents bad song with references to erections and bleach to desperately try to be edgy. And that is how I feel about this song.
There's, like, millions of words in the song. Why would you come out with the word erection?
Because why would you use the word erection in the song? How are you going to use the word erection and not have me point it out?
I feel like you heard that word and you was like, oh, damn, I love them. And then... I hope she get low because she- Right, my song next. Fashion. Yes. Willie J. I like the bit where he goes like, bam, bam, bam. Do you know that bit?
You like the guitar solo?
Yeah, he goes, bam, 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 bam. Do you know what I'm on about?
Yes, the guitar solo, George.
I really enjoyed the guitar solo. Yeah, pretty good. That's like the main thing that stood out to me.
Again, none of these have been bad, which I'm very surprised about, because normally, like, I just get a constant stream of, like, people telling me how shit my music is.
Yeah, yeah. We're all stinkers.
Your next song was the Stereotype song by Your Favourite Martian. I didn't like this either. I thought the beat was annoying. The vocals are not good. Ray William Johnson cannot sing. The comedy is less subtle than being hit on the head with a brick. Like, I did not enjoy anything about this at all. The lyrics are just like reciting dumb stereotypes.
Okay, I am fully aware watching this back that I did completely miss the point of the song, as the stereotypes being like recited in the song are so dumb, and that is kind of the point. Although my point still kind of remains that it doesn't really add much to the inherent comedy of the song, and to be fair, it doesn't really affect my overall enjoyment in any way.
What would make this song funny to me, little thought experiment for you, is if the stereotypes throughout the song got so ridiculous to the point where literally nobody says them, that would be funny. But yeah, I didn't like this song. I thought it was terrible. I didn't like it. I think I love you more than the Japanese love tentacle
porn, and we should dance, 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 dance to these stereotypes. Moving on, it was Methodemic by Black Sabbath. Yeah, shit. I really didn't like it. Just screaming down my ear pain. Oh, on this one, I liked the guitar solo again.
Right, any opinions of your own, Jack, so that we can pad this segment out a bit longer?
I really like the way that he speaks, like, in the song, in my opinion.
If it was an ice cream, it'd be pooslet flavoured.
I liked the song, but Jack didn't.
To be fair, Jack did do it, let a really big fart out whilst I was listening to the first
time. I did not.
Altered my opinion.
My next song from you was Where Are You, Nino? I didn't like this song either. I don't know what you were playing at, but, like, this is, like, I just put that it's another instance of a song, like Teen Titans Blow, of just absolutely rinsing the hell out of gay sex jokes to the point where they're not even funny.
No. This is about a serious relationship, Evan.
Shut up, George. No, it isn't. I thought it was made even worse by the fact that even if you don't listen to the lyrics, there's literally nothing to enjoy about the song, because it's not even ironically funny, because it was just made to be terrible, and so the entire concept of the song falls flat on its face. I thought the instrumental was, like, the most cheapest, like, ballad instrumental free YouTube thing I think I'd ever heard in my life. And I'm not lying when I say the last 75 seconds or so genuinely made me feel sick.
Yeah, I agree. It's a pretty good song. My song. The next song was Get Over It by Rat Boy. I really enjoyed this song. I like the "Burn when it's over," that bit. You know what I'm on about?
Yes, the chorus, George, yes.
Yeah, it's well good. Beat good. The atmosphere was absolutely electric. Yeah, it's pretty good.
I saw Rat Boy at Bingley Music Live, and so it occurred to me that this is, like, festival music. Like, this would go off at a festival. So your final song was Robbery by Juice WRLD. Apart from the fact that this song is a meme, it's actually not too bad.
But no, it's not a meme.
Have you not seen the meme where it's like, damn, I didn't know Mr. Tumble's concerts went this hard. Have you not seen that?
That's amazing.
It's so good.
That is amazing.
So aside from the fact that it's a meme, it's actually not that bad. Like, I thought,
this isn't a meme.
I know it. I know it from that meme.
No one knows it from the Mr. Tumble meme, Evan. Everyone doesn't listen to Robert and be like, oh, this is from Mr. Tumble.
Well, I actually quite enjoyed this song. It's not that bad. I thought the beat was well done. I thought the piano loop sounded quite nice. But I thought the vocals, apart from the chorus, which I did find was all right, I thought the vocals were kind of strained and kind of overdone and quite irritating, actually, just because of how, like, over the top they are. So I kind of found it a bit annoying. And I thought the outro goes on for way too long. Like, it takes a full minute of just instrumental at the end, and it does not need to be that long. So I like some bits of it, but I just find some elements of it, like, kind of annoying and tedious. Grave for my past, I'm a whole different person.
It's a gift and a curse, but I cannot... The next song was Wild Frontier from The Prodigy. Proper stinker. Never listening to it again. Rather cut my leg off, really. I also put Evan has a Slipknot for wallet.
Jack, what did you think of this song?
This is the one song which George listened to before I was actually there.
Wait, so you didn't even listen to them in order?
No.
It was too loud.
You're actually a granddad. You're such a... Oh, it's too loud. It's too loud.
Very fast. It was very fast. At some point, it's made me want to stop listening. Nearly didn't listen to the full song, but I finished it for your sake.
You might not be as familiar with this last part of the show, but what we do is we take the songs that we've been given and we give the playlist a collective rating out of 10. You can go to decimal places if you like.
0.0. Do you want me to give you a real... Right,
yes,
right,
yes, put the slightest bit of human effort in and then give it a rating.
From all of the songs that I listen to, which is every single one of them, I listen to every single song, I'll give you a solid
4.5.
4.5, right, I'll take that. It's the lowest I've had on the show so far, but I'll take that. I'd say that I don't think I could say I genuinely liked any one of your songs all the way through. I'm going to have to give yours like a 2.3. Like, it was really poor. So, thank you very much for coming on the show, George. It's been a pleasure.
I've had a good time. Don't know if you have.
No, I haven't had a good time. It's been awful. But thank you for coming.
Yeah, well, you're the one who fired on chat, so.
So, next week it should be, or next time rather, it should be back to normal. Callagher will be back in the hot seat with me once again.
He likes feet, doesn't he? I've heard that Callagher players, he likes feet.
Yeah, I believe he'll be back next time, and then the episode after that is another special guest episode, which I personally am very, very excited for.
Everyone go and add Noah Zznr on Instagram. It's NOAHHSZNN. Everyone go and add him on Instagram.
Also known as Noah Season.
Thank you for coming on once again, of course. I think it's been easily the most chaotic episode ever, but it's been very enjoyable. But thank you both for coming on.
Thank you.
I hope you've all enjoyed, and I will see you somewhere later on down the line. See you later.
Yeah. One guy.